Welcome back to my channel, and in this video I will be teaching you how you can control servo motor with micro bit board, and I will be simulating this project in Tinkercad website, which is already open, and you can go there and make an account. You can do this by yourself as well, but I'm just gonna go through each step how you can do it, and I will try to use onboard button of this micro bit board, so you can understand how you can use onboard devices and to control other things like a servo motor or DC motor and something like that. And I will proceed with further experiment in the future. Please subscribe my channel and you will and turn on the notification. So moving on to this website, just click on create new circuit, and when you open this white canvas, here on the right side you will see these components. In there you have the components. Click on all components from the drop down menu, and you can see there are so many components are there. Just bring in the micro bit board. This is the micro bit board we have here. It has two push buttons and also one button at the back, which is a reset button, which I had already showed in a previous tutorial. And it has three digital pins and 3 volt and ground pin as well. So let's bring in the servo motor. Where it is, this is a micro servo motor. Let's just rotate it. This is a ground pin. Arrange the wires so you can get a better understanding. And this one is a power connect to the 3 volt. Change the wire color as well. This should be red and this one should be black, and this is a single wire. Use P0 pin, which is a digital pin. Change its color as well. Okay, now I will try to rotate this servo motor at 180 degree or 90 degree with this micro bit board. Let's go to the code section and just remove this on start. What should be the output? Rotate servo pin 0, 2, 90 degree. Let's start the simulation. It's rotated and it stay there. We have to bring it back, so let's do this. 180 degree and wait for it 3 seconds and duplicate this one again and rotate to Z position 0. So let's start again. It's rotated to 180 degree, then it will go back. It will happen only one time. We have to make it a loop, so you can do this again and again and again. So let's bring this forever and put this section of the code here. So let's see how does it works. It's going back again, and will it come back? See, it's going through again and again and rotating servo motor, move to 180 degree and goes back to 0 degree. Let's control this servo motor with this A and B button. Okay, I will make changes to the code. Let's where are the controls? These are the controls. You can select okay input on button A pressed. What should it do? Rotate servo pin 0 to 180 degree. And what if we duplicate the same thing down there, and when the button B press, bring back to 0 degree. Let's just suppose that we are doing this way, and click start button. Okay, when I will press the button A, it will rotate to 180 degree. Wow. And I will press the button A B. Wow. It's rotating. So it's rotating. When you press A, it will rotate to 180 degree. When you press B, it will rotate back to its original position. Let's add something else. Let's just say we want to control the servo motor with a vibration sensor, which is here. When you press this, it vibrates like that, it's shaked. And let's go to controls, and do we have here, or upon shaking, what we will do? Rotate the servo motor to 90 degrees. Let's do this and check what will be the results. So start the simulation. When I start the simulation, I will click this. It will goes to 180 degree. When I press B, it goes back. And now let's just shake it. Will it goes to 90 degree? It's rotated. When I press B, it will goes back to its original position. It's on 90 degree. When I will press A, it will goes further to 180 degree. Well, that's a nice project and I liked it very much, and I'm gonna do more experiment with this microbit board. I really liked it. You can do so many things with it. And subscribe to my channel and give a like to this video if you liked it, and press that bell icon so you can get the future notification.